Hey guys, it's Carl Brown from guitarlessons365.com. Today we're going to learn how to play The Ocean by Led Zeppelin. Now I'm going to take a look at the solos and the outro section. I did it solo in some different videos, so make sure you find those as well. Right now we're going to take a look at all the chords and all the riffs in the song. So we're just going to start here with that main opening riff that everybody knows. We're in standard tuning. All right, so what's happening there is we're gonna do two quick hammer-ons from 5 to 7 on the D string. So you pretty much just hear the 7, that fifth is just kind of a ghost note. And then we have 5 on the D, 7 on the A, and then 8 on the low E, and you're gonna slide that down. So we have this. All right, then we're gonna, the first three times you play this riff, you're gonna end it like this. So we have 5-7 on the A string to 5 on the D. Then we'll do 5-7 again to 7 on the D. So we have this. All right, you can use whatever fingers. I just use my little finger there, but you can use your third finger. All right, then the fourth fret on the A to 7 on the D, up to 5th on the A, and 7. So we have then 5-7 on the A. All together. Repeat. So you repeat that 3 times. Now this fourth time is going to have a different ending. So basically the ending is you just don't go up to the 7, that very last note, you don't play it. It just leads into the first verse, which sounds like this. So it's just the same thing, kind of repeated 4 times. We have this D major chord. Now this is gonna play the 5th fret on the A, then the 7th fret across the B, G, and D string. I use my little finger for that bar. You can just use your 3rd finger, or all 3 fingers, to play each note separately. So we have this, down, up on that, then down 2 frets, same exact thing, down, up. Then we're gonna go to the A major chord. So I'm just still barring across the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th strings. Then the 3rd fret on the low E string. And then back to the A. So we have this. Then you get to pick the chord at the 3rd fret, slide it up to the 5th fret, and play it 2 more times. So we have this. Now, sometimes he doesn't do that slide, he just picks both notes. All right, so watch out for that. So from there, we go back to that main riff. But he starts adding a little bit at the end of every single of this first phrase. Okay, so you gotta be watching out for that now. 8th fret here, down, up. Then at the 7th fret once, and a quick down up on the 7th fret, so we have this. And then the same ending. And then he just plays on the 7th fret. Okay, so he's gonna add that little variation in there. When you hear that, this variation that happens at the end of this riff, starting kind of the second time of going through the riff. Or it might be playing all in the 7th. And then later in the song, he'll be doing the same riff, just kind of muting the strings in that same feel. it's just a little variation that he's adding. It still starts the same and ends the same. It's just that little variation you got to watch out for. All right, so that's pretty much going to cover those kind of three options there of what he'll be doing. Just kind of follow on the song, get it in your ear, and you'll know which one to play when. All right, so besides that, we have the second verse. All right, so that little thing I did at the end is the only thing that's different from the first verse. He's now doing the same thing, but in the dead space there, he's coming up here to the 10th fret across the B, G, and D string, and just hitting that chord and sliding down. Later on, sometimes he'll hit just the two middle strings of the 10th fret, or sometimes he'll add that B string in there. Either way, it's gonna sound fine. All right, and then from the only other thing we have to work out when it comes to riffs and stuff is going to be that little harmony section, which is very similar to this verse. Sounds like this. Alright, so this there's a couple of harmonies, like really four guitars there. I'm just kind of playing a couple of the harmonies that sound like the least dissonant and the sound the best together to recreate the sound. So we're just doing the 7th fret on the G and the B string together. Down, up, down, up. And then the same thing at the 5th fret on the B and the G. Then the 7th fret on the G and the D together. And then 5 on the D, 6 on the G. So we have this. Then back to the 2 7s on the D and the G. And then you're gonna hammer on. You're gonna pick those 2 5s again on the G and the B string. Hammer on to the 7th fret on both of the strings. And end up with a quick down up. So we have this. And now you're gonna end it with this kind of unison. Both of these are Cs. We're gonna have this, the 13th fret on the B, 17th on the G. Now, you might want to just take your middle finger and touch the high E string, so to make sure you don't hit that when you pick. And slide into those two notes with just your first finger and your third, and slide back down. It's kind of tricky at first. So once again, we're just putting together multiple guitar parts. The way he plays it is not going to be that difficult, but we're just trying to make it sound like the album with just those... just one guitar. So then coming out of that, the very ending of that, after you've done that part a few times, we have just the same thing as the main riff. Doing that full 5-7, and you're gonna end it with just a hammer-on, 5-7. And let that note just ring. All right, so this takes care of all the riffs, and we're gonna take a look at the solo and that whole outro section in other videos. So make sure you check those out. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.